Wellness Posse Wednesday, where we are trying to elevate the conversation that wellness professionals have with their clients, from quick fixes and self-hate to self-love, self-testing, and self-knowledge. And I am here with one of my very, 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 very good friends, Heather Newby. And we just figured out, we think we've been friends for like 8 years.
Yep.
And I've been wanting to, everybody knows that the Wellness Posse knows that I'm very big into mental health and that it, I really do believe it all starts with what's going on in between your ears.
Thank you.
And
yes.
So I'm super excited to have my first,
yay,
you know, therapist, mental health professional on Wellness Posse Wednesday, because I really do feel like if we don't get to the core of why you're doing things and unpack kind of all of that stuff, mm-hmm, that we continue to repeat the same behaviors over and over again.
Amen, sister. Amen.
So I'm going to let Heather just introduce herself and tell kind of the Wellness Posse what you do and who you are.
Thank you. Hello, Wellness Posse. I am Heather Newby. I am a licensed professional counselor here in Austin, Texas, in Central Austin. We're in my office right now.
Yeah,
welcome.
Lovely.
It's kind of weird. I'm not used to sitting on the couch, but it's comfy.
Come on down. You can sit on Heather's couch.
I work a lot with women and caregivers, and I love working with caregivers because I feel like we are all so socialized into giving, 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 mm-hmm, that we forget that we should be part of who we're caring for. And to get to see women actually start doing that for themselves and see their lives shift and how not only does their life get better, but everyone around their lives gets better,
mm-hmm,
it's very rewarding. It's kind of fun. So that's me. That's what I do.
That's awesome. We're just going to jump on in like we normally do.
Okay.
So tell the Wellness Posse, what would you think kind of your wellness philosophy would be in a few sentences?
Balance. I think that finding a good balance in your life of, well, the whole mind, body, spirit thing is really important. And I think a lot of times we find one thing that works for us and we start going down that path like bull in a china shop type. And then we let other things go off. So then we get off kilter and we kind of tilt and we fall or we fail or we do something that makes us feel unsuccessful when really, you know, there's a good place to kind of work it all in, you know, mm-hmm, kind of figuring out, well, why did that happen? And taking a step back and going, okay, well, yeah, I was working out like a demon, but I wasn't eating right or I wasn't taking care of myself and, you know, mentally, mm-hmm, kind of just keeping balance in your life. That was way more than 3 sentences. I'm sorry.
That's okay. It doesn't matter. 3 sentences is just
all
the
good
framework.
Yeah.
How did you haven't always been, like me,
no,
had a very windy-ass road, ended
yes
up doing what you're doing at an older age.
Fabulously older age.
Yeah, so tell people kind of how did you end up becoming a therapist and what did that path look like, because it's not kind of standard. I went to college and this is what I've been doing.
No, I was 37 years old. I was working in a very lucrative sales career and completely miserable. Just didn't feel like anything was in balance in my life. And one day I was out on Lake Austin with my good girlfriend Jamie Tower.
Shout out
to Jim Tower. I don't even think she's on Facebook. That's okay.
Virtual shout out
to Jamie. We were talking about relationships and she said, you know, you should maybe think about getting your master's in counseling. That was in August of 2009, and by January, no, that was actually further back than that. God, that was almost 10 years ago. That was August, and January I was sitting in a classroom. It just felt right. It's been 9 years since I started this journey, and
that's crazy to
had
say.
Its ups and downs and all kinds of windy roads, but I've never been happier, and it feels good to be kind of going in the right direction, you know.
Yeah.
Even though it does have its twists and turns, I know I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing, and for the longest time, I just wasn't.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just the short, that's how I got the immediate thing. I mean, there were family business,
and not being in alignment, and money versus not knowing, you know, insecurity, security versus insecurity, and how so many people get stuck kind of feeling, you know, secure but miserable.
Right. I have all this load of cash, but...
Lucky you!
Woo!
But I hate my life.
But I'm so miserable that I'm outspending it every single night. I'm not saving any of it. I was in that position. I was in a lucrative career, but I hated it. And I was spending everything that was coming in going out searching for happiness. Mm-hmm. And
trying to buy your
I lost that lucrative sales job 1 month or like right before my midterms, which rightfully so, you know.
Thank you, universe, for freeing up my schedule.
My apologies to that company.
So sorry about that.
So sorry. I was miserable. I'm so sorry. I think once you kind of start figuring it out, and that maybe that is taking a step back from where you are, taking a deep breath. I took the next, I took a long time off after losing that job and just worked on my studies until I found a job that allowed me to, that knew what my path was and allowed me to go down that path, supported me miraculously. Shout out to LifeWorks. Love you.
Love you, LifeWorks. Yes, we do love LifeWorks.
Brett Barnes.
Yeah, we love you, Brett Barnes.
This is just going to be a shout-out segment.
We're going to hashtag a lot of people at the bottom. Tag you, everyone.
Anyway, so sometimes you really do have to take a big, huge step back, whether that's emotionally, financially. You could just go across the whole board.
Yeah.
To go, you got to clear out the muck.
Yeah.
Clear it out, get down to bottom brass tacks, and just figure out what feels, what do I want to put back in?
Mm-hmm.
Let's empty it out. I've always said, when I clean my closet, I have to take everything out of my closet and then put it all back in and see what goes back in, what fits in there at that time, because sometimes you hold on to things that you hold on to for some reason that you just don't even know why. It's because it's there.
Yeah.
Because it's been in your closet since you were 20 years old.
I've always had these bootcut jeans, acid wash bootcut jeans. I just can't let them.
I don't know where. But what if
they might come back?
My excuse, and I have a box. I'm like, but what if there's a costume on it? And I need it. Michael is like, I'm sorry. you've got to get rid of that, seriously.
Yeah.
But really kind of getting down to the basics and seeing what really does feel good going back into your life.
Yeah, I love that idea of cleaning stuff out. Mm-hmm. It works the same way with your system. I'm not a big fan of, like, juice cleanses, but I am a fan of don't eat like a dum-dum cleanse, where you spend a few weeks eating really clean, because then as soon as you start eating something again, you're like, you know what? I don't think this agrees with me. Thank you, red lentils. Red lentils don't agree with me. I don't know what the deal is. It still looks very rude, but yellow lentils all day long. Red lentils don't agree. There we go.
No red lentils for Allie's dinner.
No red lentils.
Good to know.
How do you feel like what, I mean, that is kind of one of the conversations we talked about as kind of realigning and listening to yourself, but what are those other conversations that you wish wellness professionals were having with their clientele that you don't kind of hear them having as much as you wish they were?
Well, that there isn't one answer for everyone.
Yeah.
That there are different ways to do things, and I think it leads to so many craziness. And we were talking earlier about comparison. Like, my best friend is really into paleo, or my best friend sees this therapist, or, you know, they do this. And that doesn't necessarily mean that that's the right person for you, that that's the right fit for you. And that's why it's so great to be able to kind of go and you can, it's easy to try a paleo diet for a little while. There's fabulous cookbooks out there you can try. Or a lot of therapists will allow you a free 15, 20 minute conversation mm-hmm. on the phone where you can call them and kind of ask them questions. That's what that time is for. It's for you to ask questions and see, does this person align with me and does this feel good?
Yeah.
And am I going to be able to go into that space with them and connect and do the work that maybe isn't going to be that easy at times and really kind of get down to what needs to be done.
Yeah, this whole militant that it's my way or the highway, and this
right.
is the only way in which you can be healthy,
yeah.
is like the most asinine thing I've ever
dangerous.
Heard. Yeah. I mean, as I really do believe as wellness professionals, our main thing is to educate people.
Absolutely.
And that there are so many modalities in mm-hmm. which to be healthy, mm-hmm. and your background, and your genetics, and your...
Oh.
How you were raised and
well,
your
you
current
happy?
Lifestyle
yeah.
are they're so vastly different for every person, and not everything is going to fit everybody's lifestyle, and it
thank
should
you.
Not,
no.
and it will not.
That's why we have variety.
Thank goodness. Thank goodness.
Goodness.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
absolutely.
Yes, completely. It's not one way or the other. It's
mm-hmm.
not just one way. It's
no
every ways. But
any
the only way.
Way
you can do that. Is to really be open to experimentation, trying different things out,
right.
and maybe something did work for you. This
right.
is another thing we talked about.
One point in your life that felt really good, you know, you're in your 20s, maybe jazzercise was the great thing to do. That was my 20s, sorry. It probably wasn't everybody else's
20s. I don't know, jazzercise
oh, well.
Is easy. You got to wear a thong. That
I
was
see
fun.
Your video, that was great. now I'm flushed with that, I'm sorry. I'm distracted. But... You know, being able to figure out what feels good now, because it's one time, you know, that talking down, going down with, you know, the one direction and not being able to stop at some point and go, wait a minute, this doesn't feel right.
Mm-hmm.
Because everybody's telling you it should feel right. It should
mm-hmm.
feel right. But then you don't feel right. And then that makes it feel even worse
mm-hmm.
because
like you must
like
be doing it wrong.
Like you're not doing it right. Well, no, you're not doing it. You're doing it perfectly fine. It's just not working for you.
Yeah.
And you need to try something different.
Yeah.
Take a step back. Go, okay, what, you know, obviously red lentils are not your thing. let's see what some, maybe some black beans will do for
yeah,
you.
Exactly.
You don't know. Could be something a little different.
What are three things that you would that everybody could kind of implement that would help them be healthier?
Oh gosh, well, trust your gut. Those are big ones. I hear more people and not say, you know, it just didn't feel right, but I thought, you know, no, it's just me. Well, no, that's your system telling you, please, take a moment, take a step. It's your intuition.
Mm-hmm.
It's everything kicking in. I also say trust your gut again, because like 80 to 95% of the serotonin in your body is produced in your gut. It is responsible for your bowel movements. It is responsible for that kind of that butterfly feeling that
mm-hmm.
you get. That's your levels kicking up going, ooh, what's that?
Mm-hmm.
Getting in touch with your body and your system and listening and understanding that, you know, it's trying to tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of, you know, sometimes good things can make that the butterflies come up too. And that's great. If you're about to jump out of a plane and you're all attached and you're good to go, then that's normal. But also, if you're about to walk down an alley late at night, that's not normal. You should probably not walk down that alley. Or
yeah.
if you get that weird intuition, listen to it.
Uh-huh.
It's really important.
Yeah.
And equally as important is learning how to set boundaries. That's a really big thing for everyone. I hate to say women in particular, but we are socialized to kind of be caregivers and almost give ourselves away a little bit
mm-hmm.
to everything. It may be, you know, taking the kids to a soccer game and then a play group and then coming home and making sure dinner is ready and then talking to your best friend for an hour and then at the end of the day, that's all fine and great as long as you remember to be a caregiver for yourself, too. And that you're not just being compassionate to everyone else, but you're being compassionate to yourself.
Yeah.
And taking care of you. Because if you don't have the proper boundaries set up, then you're going to get lost in there. Mm-hmm. And that's what happens to so many people, is that you don't have the proper boundaries, and so you get engulfed in everybody else's stuff, and you get lost, and then you get down the road, and you're like, I don't know who I am anymore. And, mm-hmm. well, yeah, let's come on in. We'll set up some boundaries, and we'll help you figure that out. And mm-hmm. and it allows you to be a better caregiver. If you have your boundaries set to where, you know yourself, and you know what's right for you, and you're able to, in that moment, not come back, it's like the Costanza, what I meant to say, 3 hours later, and you're like, what are we talking about? But if you're able to say it in that moment and kind of go, hey, that's not cool,
this isn't working for me,
what's going on for you, because it's, my gut just kicked in, and I don't feel right, so the more that you practice that, the easier it becomes.
Yeah.
And the easier that it becomes for everybody around you, too.
Yeah.
Because then they learn your boundaries. And it actually lets people be more close to you.
Yeah. Explain that you were saying, because I feel like a lot of people view the word boundaries as like, mm-hmm. well, this is my, almost
right.
being like right. putting up walls,
like,
and this
wall.
Is me, like,
right.
people should
right.
know not to cross my line.
Well,
which they should.
Right, they
but,
should. But it's, I think it, yeah, that's taking it to the extreme, and a lot of times that's how we have to do it, and that's how it starts, is that if you're at that point where you're like, this is my line, and this is where it's going to end, and then you've probably had your boundaries crossed.
For probably a significant amount of time, and then all of a sudden you're
mm-hmm.
so engulfed that you're like,
right.
oh.
Your guard is up.
Yeah.
It is walls.
Yeah.
And we are talking about walls at that point. But it's really kind of more about getting to know yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Getting to know what feels good, what doesn't feel good, and being honest about it, being
mm-hmm.
upfront about it, trying to be, like, I don't know, it's not as easy as, now I just lost my train of thought, but completely got off track.
Yeah.
But anyway, so setting the boundaries, that really lost my train of thought. I just zoned out.
Okay. It doesn't matter.
I think I've had a senior moment. Apologize.
So we had talked about, I think it's a really good thing, is there, what kind of way would you say would be an easy way for people to start setting boundaries, or how do you kind of even
right.
approach doing that
well,
for yourself?
Yeah, that's okay. There you go. Thank you. Listening to your system. I wasn't listening to my system, everyone. Listening to what's going on and realizing it goes back to trusting your gut.
Okay.
It really does. It goes back to kind of figuring out when something doesn't feel right. And being honest with yourself, kind of going, why didn't that feel good for me?
Mm-hmm.
Where's that coming from? And then reestablishing, if you start feeling it happening again, being honest about it and saying, hey, this isn't working for me. So let's just kind of go back, thinking about your past, thinking about your history and why
mm-hmm.
why things may be coming up for you.
Yeah.
That really has a lot to do, and like when you get to that point where your walls are going up, a lot of times that has to do with some boundary that's been crossed for you
mm-hmm.
In your history, that it may have absolutely nothing to do with the person that you're sitting there with, but it may have something to do with somebody else that stole food off your plate. I mean, it could be as simple as that.
Yeah, I don't like to share my food.
I don't like
because
to share my food because so-and-so used to eat everything that I liked on the plate and then left me with what I didn't like. I mean, it's as simple as that. Explaining it, trying to figure out what it is, and then being able to actually explain it to the person you're sitting there with. And they're going to like, oh, so it's not me. It's this other person.
Yeah.
And I won't steal your fries anymore. I apologize.
Please don't touch my fries.
Please don't touch my fries. Exactly.
What's one wellness myth that you wish could be busted.
Oh, I think that's the whole thing, that there's one thing for when one size does not fit everyone.
Yes, one size does not fit all. Or most.
Or most, or any of that. And that failure is bad.
That was the one that we had talked about.
Growth. Anytime something, you have to fail to grow. And so a lot of people are like, there's no room for that. No, there has to be room for that. Otherwise, you're not expanding.
Yeah, we had talked about kind of feeling uneasy and stepping into uneasy, as opposed to backpedal into comfort. And how so many people, they kind of get to that level,
right?
And they're like, oh, I am trusting my gut. This feels bad, so I'll just stay over here in comfort land.
Right.
And kind of explain the difference between those.
Yes.
Because I think a lot of people use that as an excuse of, oh, this doesn't feel good.
Good point. And that's a good way of using my own words against me.
No, I mean, but that no, I hear that no, too. But, they're like, but you said it's not supposed to hurt.
That's not exactly what I meant. Yeah, I've actually worked it into my first session spiel that there are going to be times where things get uncomfortable and that it does hurt, and that's probably the time that you're really getting into the actual work.
Mm-hmm.
When you're doing a new workout and you actually pushed yourself and it feels, but it's getting to the other side of that.
Mm-hmm.
You do feel better. Mm-hmm. You have to kind of keep taking some little step forward in order to make that progress, to get to feel growth and success. And it may just be like the tiniest little baby step possible, but at least you moved.
Yeah.
And honestly, sometimes that step is backwards. Sometimes it is. Sometimes you can take a step back and go, okay, I need to breathe, but then you do that with full knowledge that you're giving yourself a little space and that I'm going to actually proceed forward from here.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you gotta give yourself, maybe it's a sidestep, maybe it's a dance, there it is.
We both like dancing.
Yes.
So speaking of that, like hitting kind of a roadblock, or kind of feeling like you've gotten out of alignment, what are the kind of, all of us, every human, here we go, here's
all
Deep
us.
Thoughts by Allison. Every human gets to that point, even wellness professionals, get to that point where you look at your life and go like, what the hell happened? And how did I get here? And this is not where I want to be.
This is not my beautiful house.
Yeah. Exactly. So could you kind of share with everybody, is there a time that you can think of that's happened to you, and how did you navigate that and kind of get yourself back on track?
Well, it happens all the time. Happened last week. No, it does. It just happens. If you are someone who's working on yourself and you're constantly trying to live a full, better life, there's going to be days that you wake up and you just feel off. And I get those, frequently, where you kind of go, ugh. But you have those things in place, be it a good support system, a workout, something that you know that will help you kind of clear your head to see to the other side of it, that kind of helps you through things. I think we all just, a lot of times for me, when that happens for me, is if I'm not paying attention or if I'm just cruising through and I haven't really stopped to breathe or think about what's going on, and then I'll get to a quiet moment and I'll be like, well, how did I get here? What's this? What's going on? And taking time to kind of reflect back and see how you got there.
Yeah.
And is this still the direction I want to be going in? And looking at it.
So like a check-in. Reassess.
Yeah, reassess and sounds good.
So we are on to our rapid fire.
Woo!
We are calling it wildfire. wellness round questions. I have to get my notebook because I never remember these. Do you follow any or like any kind of, we're going to tone it to mental health because you're a mental health professional. So mental health professionals that you like to follow, books, people, podcasts, anything like that?
Yes. I think that the Four Agreements.
I love that book.
I think that should be mandatory reading.
For everyone.
For everyone. All people. It's the most common sense that you'll ever read in your entire life, but for some reason, it's what we all forget.
Yes.
Be impeccable with your word. Don't take anything personally.
It's amazing.
Yeah. Really, it is. I love Kristen Neff. She's actually here at UT. She does a lot of work in self-compassion. Mm-hmm. She's amazing. And the Gottman Institute. For anything relationship, I love them. They're in Seattle. They've been studying relationships for over 40 years. Mm-hmm. They have the Love Lab in Seattle, where they have been studying just how people get along. I can't remember what the stat is, but he can guess whether people are going to get a divorce within like, I think 89% of the time he's right, or something maybe even bigger than that.
I don't know. It's pretty amazing.
He's amazing. Yeah. I think he's an actual guru in my field.
Yeah.
So I'm like, oh. So yeah, those are my people.
Do you have a morning or an evening routine?
That's kind of do. It's a little bit every morning. I snuggle up with my man. It's like we have a morning. Like even
shout out Michael.
It's like every morning we have to have like our cuddle time, just to kind of like before we go to bed, and the Shih Tzu. She rolls it down.
She's so cute.
She's adorable. She's not so bright, but she sure is pretty. and in the evenings, I try to read in the evenings a little bit. It helps me go to sleep. But
do you read fiction or nonfiction?
A lot of times, really wanting to, I love reading fiction. Just James Patterson is my guilty pleasure.
Yeah.
It's just something that kind of steps me out of what I do all day long, and it's the most ridiculous talking about Ferraris and fun things like that. I don't know, it's silliness, but
I can't. Nonfiction is hard for me to read before I go to bed because I feel like it actually activates my mind.
Oh,
but fiction,
yeah.
I feel like it can kind of zone me back, kind of relax me.
Yeah,
I listen to mostly nonfiction, but I read at night mostly fiction.
Yeah.
What's your spirit animal?
Oh, God. I wish and I thrive that I hope that someday my spirit animal will be the owl with the wisdom.
Oh, I
like to be wise.
Hooty hoo hoo.
Hooty hoo hoo. And I'm used to more neck flexibility. not quite that much, but right now, probably a Shih Tzu. Who knows? That's what I spend most of my time with.
What do you feel like your superpower is?
Oh, wow, superpower. Brutal honesty.
She is very honest. And I would say, as your friend, she is very empathetic.
Thank you very much. I try to be empathetic around my brutal honesty.
That's how I am. That's why we get along.
No, maybe that's why we're such good friends.
Exactly. Because we ain't no bullshit, but we feel you.
Well, I feel you, honey, but
you're being dumb.
It ain't working. I love you and all, but
I love you, but that's dumb.
That's just no.
That's not awesome. Happening. What advice would you give to your 16-year-old self? Don't wear those jeans.
Please stop. No. So this is hard for me because as a therapist, I want to just take myself in and everything. But as a 46-year-old version, 30 years later, I want to go, get over yourself. It's, it's going to be okay.
Yeah.
But please take a step back. Think. I was kind of, my mom says I was great. but
but she didn't know everything.
She loved me. I was a brat. Yeah. You know, I came back honestly. So
yeah.
Like I said, the therapist side of me would have some really wise things to say, but the me side of me, but as looking back and going, stop it.
Well, that's all we have for Wellness Posse Wednesdays. Thank you for being
here.
So let's share with everybody like what's coming up for you, where can people find you and work with you, and then like any final thoughts you have.
Well, thank you. So I am located at 3400 Kirby Lane. It's Esteem Austin Counseling. And I work primarily with women, but I also do really great couples workshops geared towards making your relationship stronger. I do one that's really cool called Bringing Baby Home, that's geared towards families who are either expecting or just had a baby, and it's really a very exciting time, but everything in your life is changing. Mm-hmm. So it's a great workshop to kind of allow you to have some really cool tools in your box when you bring that baby home. You're like, what the heck did we just do? It's all exciting, but kind of gives you some really good tools to stay connected with each other, as well as understand what's going on with your baby too.
Love that. I work with so many moms, and that is such a hard time. Everybody knows that it's a hard time for the mom, but it's a very stressful time for the couple in general. And that a lot of times, if it's not well managed or cared for, it can cause a rift that, if over long term, can be the thing that ends the marriage. I mean, all of us have known so many people that have had kids, and then at some point wake up and be like, it all changed after the kids, and now we don't know
each other anymore.
It's really sad.
It really is. So I think that's a really important thing to learn. And I'm working with a previous Wellness Posse lady, Miss Meg Stanley.
Shout out Meg Stanley!
Yay! On her Women Lifting Women Summit, which is coming up.
Which I'm also going to be at. Yes. You can meet both of us in one place.
Speaker here. and we are looking for a venue.
Yes.
September 22nd. We need a place that can hold, you know, anywhere from 60 to maybe, you know, it'd be lovely if we get 200 people. So reach out to either me or Meg if you have an idea, or if you want to donate anything.
Yeah, if you have a cool space or you want to get your stuff in front of some awesome women, come on.
Yeah,
join us, Women Lifting Women.
We're really
women.
Excited about it.
It's going to be amazing.
That's me, and thank you for having me. This
was
fun.
Thank you.
Yay.
Good to see you.
Oh, you too, baby.
Okay, bye. Thank y'all. I'll see y'all next week. Y'all have a good day. Bye.